Is there a motion to return to open session?
So moved.
Thank you, Linda and Tim. No objections, we'll continue. We did meet in closed session with our board attorney. The board considered and gave instructions to the county attorney, Clyde Albright, concerning response to the claims made by the United States Department of Justice, Hall, and Byers. Is there any other commissioner comments at this time?
I'd like to bring up something in a commissioner's discussion. Concerning longevity pay, you know, seems like we were too busy to go through it and to make any suggestions or any of our thoughts during the budget time, and I think it's something we need to think about, and we need to make a decision. So what I'd like to do is do away with longevity pay up to or anything over $500,000, where the county would pay longevity pay as it is now, whatever you want to do. But it does not, that whole amount that we pay should not exceed $500,000 per year. And the new hirees, it does not cover new hirees. That would be my motion.
In other words, you were saying we eliminate in any hiring discussion the contractual relationship that a new employee, after they reached a certain period of time, no new employee.
No new employees are going to be covered by longevity.
See, back when, you know, years ago, we brought up this issue, and longevity at that time was not even $500,000, it's $400,000-some-odd, and it's doubled since then. And we did a survey, how long ago was it, about a year ago?
Yes, sir.
We did a survey, and we called around, and we had the highest longevity pay that, in general, we had the highest of any of our peers, in my opinion, based on, would you agree with that?
Very generous, yes, yeah. Sir.
And with that said, I've been concerned about it for years. Now, if we approve this, what do we do with the savings? Do we not spend it? Do we reduce the budget by that line item, $500,000? $500,000. I mean, I don't want to see that $500,000 stay in the budget to be used for something else.
I agree, yeah.
So I would
take it out of the budget.
Yeah, subtract that $500,000 from the total
salaries,
general mm-hmm. fund.
And the suggestion would probably be, since it's mid-budget year, is put it into contingency. Again, right now, contingency cannot be used unless it's a budget amendment by the Board of Commissioners.
Approved by us?
Yes, sir.
Well, see, I don't want it to go in there and be used for something else. You know, the $500,000. I mean, that's $500,000.
You want it taken off of the out of the departmental budgets.
I'd like to see us, if we're going to cut $500,000 out of longevity pay, you word it any way you want, but my word or wording of it is, if you take $500,000 out there, that's $500,000 of savings, don't put that $500,000 in savings into another arena. In other words, take your bottom line budget and knock $500,000 off of it. You understand my point?
Oh, I do.
Just put it into fund balance, can't
we? Yeah, we can put
so
it.
So were you talking about getting rid of longevity completely?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
No, well, it's going to take, but I just want to eliminate longevity pay past $500,000. That's the maximum that we should be paying for longevity pay.
That's the norm.
Yeah.
So how are you going to do that, though?
Just do it.
Yeah, but I mean, some people are going to get knocked out.
Well, what's the formula?
I would prefer to let the county manager use the formula.
Yeah, they just get lower pay raises,
but,
I think.
Yeah, but the total would be, the total in longevity pay would not exceed $500,000.
And I think, Clyde, didn't we ask you that we can adjust longevity pay?
Yes,
we just can't eliminate it on those who are already receiving it.
That's right.
But if this is the direction of the board, we can come up with a formula about the change in percentage at the next meeting and who will be receiving and percent changes.
One of the problems when I was with the health department, I mean, when I was on the board of the health department, I've seen, and I've seen it several times since then, that we hire somebody and they've been with the state 15 years and they come in as a county employee for and receiving as if they had 15 years of, the only way we should pay longevity pay if they've spent that whole time in Alamance County. Should not include any other county that they've worked in the state.
See, when we address this, we raise the floor, if I'm not mistaken. We were supposed to have raised the floor, and I've had some people debate me on whether or not we did certain things. I say we did. I was under the impression we raised the floor, that you couldn't get it unless you got to a certain level, and we capped it, supposedly.
I thought we capped it, too.
Yeah, I've been told, no, we didn't cap it. I think that's what I was told. But and let's be honest about this. People that push for the raise, push for 5%, push for more than 5% in certain arenas, that's caused this to come about. So, you know, you reap what you sow in a way, and I mean that with all due respect, but it was hard for me to vote for the budget that included all that money for raises when I knew he was pumping out $1 million in longevity. I mean, you know, I think most lay people out there who aren't getting these raises and who don't get longevity, I've never heard of longevity pay till I came into this seat. We certainly didn't get it at the bank. And when we lost bonuses, I don't know about your bank, but when we lost bonuses, you said, well, I mean, I hate I didn't get it. Maybe I'll get it next year. I mean, there was no sour grapes. There was no criticism of the board. And it just wasn't like they were owed that, you know, bonuses at the bank, any place I ever worked. But I support that. I just don't want to see us take that $500,000 in savings and say, okay, we got a $500,000 now. Now we go do this. We've approved the budget. Or the budget's been approved by the majority at a certain line item, and I'd like to see us knock $500,000 off of that. Or fund balance, if you want to put it in fund balance, that's fine.
We would reduce salary and benefits in each department by whatever amount is set in, so to equal the $500,000. But we would work on a formula and bring that back to you if that's the direction.
I'll second Bill's motion.
Okay, Bill, can you repeat your motion? Because it's really two part.
That we cap the longevity pay to no more than $500,000 per year that the county pays out. And any new employees, new hires.
As of July 1.
As of July 1, does not receive longevity
will not
pay.
Will not
ever have longevity pay as part of their salary package.
And David, you're comfortable with that second?
Yes,
second. Any other questions or discussion? My reaction, I don't have any problem at all with reviewing and having employees hired as of a certain date, whether it's July 1 or whatever, not receive it, because then the expectation would be that they're not receiving it, not participating in the program. I question whether we should put the dollar amount you're suggesting, Bill, or should we wait and let staff work on a formula that would be then presented to this board, which could result in $500,000, but it could result in something else. I'd like a little more flexibility and homework and see what the data is before we jump into the number. And that's just my reaction. That's not anything etched in stone. Well, for that reason, I would encourage the study. I would encourage Sherry's area to look at what other counties are doing in longevity pay, which I think some homework's been done in the past. And bring us that to go in that direction. But I'm a little uncomfortable of just stroking the brush and saying, okay, here's $500,000 without that kind of study. But I certainly think we should study it and have absolutely no problem with eliminating the program for new employees. That's just my reaction. But we have a motion, we have a second. So all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
No.
And I'll be no, so it'll be 3-2 passing for that. Maximum amount, Bill, of the pool of longevity funds being $500,000.
Right, that's correct.
All right, Craig, is that enough?
We'll bring you back a formula and changes to the budget at the next meeting.
Okay. Anything else to come before the board? Thank you all very much.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the commissioner's website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the county commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioner's website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.